Hello guys, and welcome to a new Steel Division video today by me, Vulcan. Today I have for you a 4 versus 4 on Carpiquet, and this is the Duellist version of the map. So we have the airfield sideways, and in this one I'm going to be playing on the Allied side of things. So I'm going to be playing with the 3rd Armoured US Division. Val's going to be playing with the 15th Infantry Scots. We're going to be having Betts on our team, who's playing the Guards Armoured, and Salt, who's using the 6th Airborne. On the Axis side, we are going to see Andrea with the 17th SS Panzer, Saraba with the Panzer Lehr, Abe with the 3rd Fallschirmjäger, and some Russian name with the 12th SS Panzer. Sorry, don't know what that means. Either way, this is a very Axis side map, so we were worried about that going into the game, and with us actually having 2 infantry divisions, it's actually quite scary. The armoured divisions aren't even that great either, because Fireflies don't really match up to Panthers very well, although I have made it work in the past. I don't have any Fireflies on my division, so I don't have to worry about that. But I do have Jumbos, so maybe they'll work out for me. But either way, what we were going to do is have Betts and Val push the left side of the airfield. They're going to be doing a double push on the left side, making use of Val's Churchill 5s alongside Betts' infantry. Then in the middle, it's just going to be myself alone controlling the entire airfield there with some recon, AT guns, machine guns, some infantry. And sorry about any background noise, by the way. I have to have my windows open today because it is just so damn hot. You know, I think you guys are lucky that I'm recording this all together, because I think I'm sitting in about 30 degrees heat, which is ridiculous. But either way, the things I do for you guys. On the right side, 6th Airborne, going to be taking control of these bunkers and hopefully pushing up against what looks to be the 17th SS Panzer. So let's go and put it into my perspective. The game started pretty damn quick, honestly. The deployment was very short. One of our opponents just set it off and off we go. It was barely ready. I think I still have points left, so you'll see me bring in some extra troops, like the M8 Scott here and another armored rifles. So I've got a couple of armored rifles here. They're going to be accompanying 3 squads of recon in their Jeep 30 cals. And then I've got multiple AT guns. I've got an AT gun on the far right with this bunker complex. I've got one for the right side of the hangars and one for the left side of the hangars. And I've got another armored rifle squad taking up position in these bunkers to assist Salt on the right side. And then, yeah, Betts and Val just going to be pushing the left really, really hard. So I've got a pretty static position at the start. I just want to take as much ground as I can, maybe push forward some of my units to take a little bit of ground. But yeah, not really going to be doing too much engagement at the start, so we'll keep an eye on the left side where we can watch Betts and Val go to work with the Cromwells and the Churchill 5s. So 3 Churchill 5s moving up together here. Look how beautiful that looks. Rolling forward slowly, 1200 meter range. We've already got HS-129 coming in and taking out one of the Cromwells, which wasn't very fun. A bit rude of our enemy there to bring that in. He's also going to be going for a shot onto the 2nd Cromwell, I believe. There is also a Beuter Firefly showing up on the left side, and that was the last thing that Val and Betts wanted to bump into, because they don't have anything at this point to deal with that. Maybe this 2-star 6-pounder could do the job, but here we can see the Cromwell 5 is going to have its tracks broken. HS-129 coming in, uses up all of its ammunition, but the Beuter Firefly is going to finish that off. 6-pounder finishes the 222, but that HS-129 already done its job alongside the Beuter Firefly. So the majority of Betts' armor is destroyed, just waiting for Vals to arrive and start crushing the infantry and AT positions. We want to get rid of this HS-129, so myself and Val have been saving 4 fighters. I'm bringing in a P-38 Lightning, going to be getting onto the tail of this HS-129. And goodbye. HS-129 goes down. Take a little bit of fire from the 20mm, and we're out. Good job. Still have the rockets available, so I'm going to be finding myself a target, which is going to be this PAC-41. Firing my rockets into that, hoping to get a decent hit. Did not. Just stunned it. That's fine. Saves That's his Humber Mark III. So the Churchill 5 there, taking out the AT gun on the left side, nice and easy. So they're just moving up now. Just don't want to get in range of the Firefly and they should be okay. Meanwhile on the right side, we can see Salt engaging with the MG42s. There's also IG-18s on that right side, and meanwhile my armoured rifles are just sitting comfy in the bunker alongside this M1 gun, and I've also got a recon squad there that was briefly fired upon, but I brought them back slightly. So Mosquito Pathfinder going to be dropping some of its napalm onto this tree line. Andrea already moved back his MG42 and the AT gun. Really good move there by Andrea, actually, to avoid that napalm landing on top of his fire support units, because, I mean, there's no point in losing them for free, right? And as soon as the napalm lands on top of an AT gun, for example, normally they just burn up and die. So that's generally what happens when napalm lands on you. Either way, in the middle, you can see Val's about to bring in a Churchill 5. And this is going to be the springboard for me to attack across the open, because I need to deal with as many AT guns as possible. So currently, I'm sort of staging all of my half tracks, my Jeep 30 cals, the M8 Scott, and I'm also bringing up another Stuart here to join me. And basically the idea is to push forwards with all of these units and take the hangars on the other side. So got the armored rifles getting into position. They're moving up ahead of the rest of my units just to make sure they have enough time to run across as soon as the engagement begins. But we are going to be having that spoilt by a 258, which is a really nice unit to use, the 9 HE power. They're going to be pinning down my armoured rifles in the open, and I'm going to be forced to fall them back. Recon in the open, look how much we can see, it's beautiful. Recon being used really well here, this recon unit, hiding in these bushes in the middle of the runway, providing a lot of information. Over on the left side too, Crusader AA, Churchill 5's easily able to take care of the Pack 41 and the Fallschirmjägers there. So goodbye to the Pack 41. And Abe's not having a fantastic time against all of these Cromwells and armoured support. So this M1 gun's now under the fire of the MG42. My recon squad goes down on the right to the IG-18. So I'm going to be bringing in a P-38 Lightning just to try and get rid of that IG-18. It was only on 2 health, so one rocket hitting should do the job. However, Lightning's just so lackluster these days. You need a direct hit with those rockets to actually do the damage, and often they do not hit. Fighter is brought in to deal with my P-38, but I'm just going to be getting that out of there nice and easy after it's forced to fall back. So I did one damage to the IG-18, second rocket didn't hit, so it's going to get away this time around. 50 cal on top of the M8 Scott opens up to the ME-109. I'm just waiting on a second Stuart here and the Churchill 5 before we move up. Meanwhile on the left side, just the 3 units of Churchills continuing their push. As soon as any infantry reveals itself to a Churchill 5, they get hit very hard thanks to the 13 HE value. Be ready. So ME-109 is just busy flying around over my 50 cal. Over on this right side, Salt's using these 3-inch mortars. Does have these 2-star mortars, and they fire very quickly, so making good use of those to damage a lot of the fire support that he's up against. Needs to get rid of the AT guns, the MGs, and maybe enemy mortars, and he'll be good to continue pushing. He's also got a Tetrarch CS there, 9 HE power again, good for taking out these MG42s. So up comes the Churchill 5, it's engaging the half track. At this point I was telling Val that it should probably actually attack the Pack 38, but we've got to remember that Val is focusing on the left side, so I kept having to relay orders to him for that Churchill 5 just so that he could pay attention to it and get it to fire at the right things, because otherwise what would end up happening is he would just attack me forwards, he would attack random things when I need it specifically to attack these AT guns from out of range. Over on the right side, managed to catch on to an ME-109 with my Mustang. So that Mustang coming in there, doing a great job. Going to be shooting down the ME-109, gets hit very hard by AA, but does get the kill, so fantastic. One fighter down. The Churchill 5 takes out the AT gun in the center. Meanwhile, on the left, it's a multitude of AT guns, Churchill 5s, Honey Stewarts, and these riflemen just pushing forwards at the moment. Try not to get caught out by these AT guns that are sneaking up. can see that's pretty much all our opponent is buying. Check out this lot. 1, 2, 3 pack 38s waiting for this charge. Me staging this right in front of them, it was kind of obvious this was going to happen, but I was very much relying on the Churchill 5 here to stop things from getting out of hand. LG 40 does go down. As soon as we take care of all these pack 38s, though, we can just ruin them entirely. We can push directly onto this infantry and so on. But at the moment, here we go. Aftrax lead in the way, supported by the M8 Scott and the Stuart there. If I go to my perspective, we're starting to reveal these AT guns as we move forwards. My infantry is making the run, my half-track's taking the shots. Pack 38's being pinned down one at a time. We also saw the P-38 Lightning here come in and stun the right side AT gun there, but that's one down, two to go. Jeep 30 cals are being knocked out, but that's fine. They're there for bait, pretty much. If they can provide fire support, great. Otherwise, they just draw fire, which is fantastic. And we're going to see the Cromwell 5 take out the Panzerwerfer as well. Bet's getting a fantastic kill there. I believe my M5A1 took out the 258, which is another great kill. And now this M1 gun's going for the kill onto the second 258. Although the 251 is going to be moving forwards and baiting the AT gun there. The Churchill 5 needs to be firing at the AT gun again. I'm going to be trying to basically fire position that area, but Salt comes in with a Pathfinder just out of the blue. Lovely little help there he provided to take care of that AT gun. Now one left on the right side, and although I've lost one of my half tracks and a couple of the Jeep 30 cals, we're in a pretty decent position still. Armoured rifles pushing up from the hangars, and I'm going to be bringing in some more reinforcing infantry now. So in Phase A, it's pretty hard to pull off a push like this as the 3rd Armoured, but with the support of Val, makes it work. Because I've only got 65 points per minute to work with, so pushing hard in Phase A is actually pretty difficult. But either way, Churchill 5 is going to be taking out the last of those three AT guns, and now I'm pretty much safe to push forwards hard with these half tracks. Going to be seeing a ME-109 come in there, take out my AT gun in the middle of the field. We've also got ME-109s hitting my Stuarts and forcing them to fall back briefly. Do have a Mustang, gets onto the back of one of the ME-109s to shoot it down, so that was very nice. But the push continues, and over on this left side, things are pushing on forwards as well with Val, since he does have the Churchill 5s in position, and there's not too much ahead of them. So making combined pushes in two areas at once. Churchill 5's taking care of this MG42 here that's busy pinning down my armoured rifle, so that was very helpful. Jeep 30 cal goes down to the MG42, and this recon squad's caught out in the open at the moment. On the right side, things are pretty precarious, honestly, for Salt. Doesn't have too much defending, but plenty of fire support. He's got these M1 howitzers. These are 3-star. They fire very quickly. Great for taking care of these IG-18s, so fantastic use of those and these mortars. Churchill 5 going for the kill onto the MG42 there. Spitfire Mark 9. I tell Betts to reroute that to the Pack 38 that's coming in. And he's going to be getting that kill with the bombs. So lovely, lovely strike there from Betts to pick off that AT gun. Definitely relieves the pressure a bit more in the center. My half tracks are coming up now for the deadly attack into the hangars. Without any AT guns here, it's very hard for him to stop these half tracks going exactly where they want. There is a spare troop here. They're going to be using grenades onto the M3 half tracks. They're going to be engaging them directly with the armored rifles. The armored rifles, though, take the shots from Bolschenjägers, MG34s, Black 38. Meanwhile, my other half tracks move into the other hangars. So this armored rifle gets hammered really, really hard and does end up dying to the spare troop. But it has allowed me time to get half tracks into position. This AT gun actually misses its shot onto my half track, so it gives us time to pin that down as well. You take out these Bolschenjägers, all the fire support's coming along. I've managed to get my Stuart up into the 600 meter range to use its 30 cal machine guns. This Stuart's moving on up, ignoring the LG-40 entirely. but there's a Tiger E on the horizon. However, I've made the ground I want to. I've got units into the far side hangars, which was the plan from the start. So, 62% territory. Really nice push across the open there. These two ME-109s actually managed to destroy my Stuart with a HE rocket strike, which was unfortunate, but still, good job all round. Armoured rifles actually managed to pick off the Fallschirmjägers there before the lightning lands the rocket strike. So a pretty solid push here, kept up the recon, allowed us to push on through with the help of Val's Churchill 5, but now we just got to be a bit scared of this Tiger E. Need to be moving the recon a little bit further up, honestly, so that we can see the extra stuff that's coming. My P-38's going to be engaged upon by a Focke Wulf 190, but I got a Mustang in the sky, so we're going to be engaging that. We also have Val bringing in two Spitfires. So getting onto the back of the Focke Wulf 190 there, trying to do my best. Andrea's going to fend me off for now. But in comes Val with the two Spitfires. Is he going to get away? Yes, he is. The AA they had on that right side was really hard to deal with. So since our initial push already worked out, I already had reinforcements coming in, more units of armored rifles alongside an armored leader this time. I forgot my armored leader the first time round, which could have been a problem, but it didn't end up mattering. One of the armored rifles actually managed to run the entire airfield and get into a hangar in the end, which was really like hero. That was a really hero play. This scout is now being picked off by a 258. Not too much of a problem. As long as we can keep line of sight onto the Panzer IV and the Tiger E. Not entirely sure what Betz's Humber Mark III is going for there, but it's going to be taken out. So we secured the left side of the hangars anyway, and that's more than enough. They can't really approach my armored rifles because of the bazookas. So as long as they remain hidden in those hangars, we should be fine. Now I've just got to get my other half tracks up, and what you can see me doing here is actually moving all of these half tracks over to the left side with fast move orders. And basically this is so that I can mass them here and push on forwards with Betz and Val. What's going to happen up here? Fallschirmjäger actually shoots my half track, forces my armored rifles to surrender. Cromwell comes in with the shot afterwards, which was unfortunate because it would have been nice to allow my half track to drive through there and unload on the left side of the tree line to stop the Stug killing them, but didn't work out in the end. ME-109 is going to get hit very hard by the tripolstons of Val. We're also going to see the 50 cals of the half tracks open up there as well. P-38 Lightning going to be engaging the ME-109. That's going to be engaged by Betz's Spitfire as well. Well, the amount of fire coming up from these tripolstons just rips that ME-109 to shreds, especially after it had already been damaged by the initial engagement. So over on the right, Salt is actually making a decent amount of ground here. He's pushing forwards with these Bren group alongside an airborne leader, just trying to clean up these Panzergrenadiers and Panzergrenadierfuhrer to make some ground up here. And if he can take control of this building, for example, and these orchards, he should have a good foothold in order to push more infantry up there and maintain his lead on that side. So Salt was doing a fantastic job. I'm beginning to spread out my half tracks on this side, ready to push on up, but we don't really have much to deal with Whitman right now, so Whitman's just going to have a free shot at a couple of my half tracks. Probably my bad for even letting them have those kills in the first place, but it is what it is. Bails out two of my M3s. Only one of them's the 50 cal variants, and the 50 cal variants are really all I care about. So losing one of those is a problem. Losing the 30 cal versions is not so much of an issue. The 50 cal versions are just so much better because of the extra range. By the way, Salt's continuing his engagement with the Tetrarch CS in the center. My M1 gun is being engaged from out of range by the Tiger E. This is a 3-star Tiger E, not going to miss very much, and going to be taking that AT gun out no problemo. So bringing up a larger AT gun now alongside Val's 17-pounder. He also already has one on the field, and Betz has brought one up to assist my infantry on this left side. You can see I've spread out a few more units, the armored rifles providing veterancy for, or my armoured leader, providing better speed for the armoured rifles. Should have probably moved them back so that they're in range of the 17-pounder here, especially considering it's engaging the Tiger E. But I didn't notice that it was just out of range there at the time. Armoured LMG rifles taking up that bunker very nicely, so that was a decent position there. More air force coming in, there was large air engagement throughout the game. So ME-109s being forced back again by the Tripolstons, but definitely kill off that AT gun before evacuating. The 17-pounder is now pinned down, bringing up a jumbo on the left side of the airfield to assist. And what we want to do here is get these vehicles caught in a crossfire. So my jumbo can actually bait the shots from the Tiger E and the Panzer IVs. Then what we can do is roll up the M5 gun and the 17-pounder and shoot them in side armor. Get my P-38 here to stun the MG-42, and I also stun the Panzergrenadiers here for salts to continue advancing. My armoured LMG rifles are taking the shots from the Tiger E, Betz's 17-pounder opening up onto the Tiger E once again. Panzer IV is going to be finishing that off, but not before he takes out the 2431. And there we have the 17-pounder of Vals bailing the Tiger E. Great job. It's a +2 in our favour. Vals 17-pounder does have the extra veterancy from the rifle leader now. So Panzer IVs don't really stand a chance, especially with my jumbo shooting them as well. 17-pounder going to get another kill there. Going to finish off the Tiger now. And he's got all of the time in the world to deal with this last Panzer IV. The Tiger E is the only real threat. My jumbo can easily deal with the Panzer IV. Now we are kind of on the time limit here. We are just about to come up to Phase C. And when Phase C comes about, we are going to be seeing, of course, King Tigers from the Panzer Lair if he saves up for them. And those could be an issue. But at this point, we have an overwhelming victory. 63% of the map. I'll say overwhelming lead, not an overwhelming victory. And it's going to be hard for them to come back from losing 1,700 points down. So we've made real good progress in the early game thanks to the Churchill 5s, the AT guns, and the infantry pushes that we've been doing. And basically, I guess the only thing that the opponents really could have done is maybe got the 17th SS player to spread out some IG-18s elsewhere to like negate the infantry pushes. But they also needed to like use that Firefly more effectively. It kind of sat behind the bunker for so long when it should have really been going for the kills onto the Churchill 5s. Either way, Jumbo's going to be engaging the Panzer IV there. It's going to be knocking out the shooter. Panzer IV's pretty much got no penetration chance onto the Jumbo. Going to be seeing the Churchill 5 engage the Panzer IV there. And just continuing that forwards. Got another jumbo coming up, this time on the right side of the runway. That's done on purpose. I wanted, if the extra units kept coming, like the Tigers and the Panzer IVs and so on, I wanted to be able to shoot them in the side armor, so having them come in from two different angles would have worked out nicely. What's going to happen here? Mustang evacs in the wrong direction, and I'm going to lose one of my Mustangs there. Mustangs trying to deal with the ME-109s. ME-109s fly directly over the Tripolstins. I bring in a Mustang to try and return the kills here, but what's going to happen? Verbalwind is going to start pinning down all of my planes, and the ME-109's got a nice crossfire onto the P-38 there, but the Verbalwind is going to finish the job. So I lose two planes in that engagement, which wasn't ideal, but wasn't too bad. I still have plenty of Mustangs. I actually stack this division with absolutely tons of Mustangs just so that I can always maintain air domination so that they don't have any like HS-129s and so on to kill my jumbos. That's pretty much the whole idea of my air tab in this division. On the right side, Typhoon Bomber going to be going down. Mosquito Pathfinder going for the napalm strike onto the Black Villings there. It's also got the howitzers firing away. So while that flakvilling burns to death, it's also being hit by howitzer fire. Churchill 5's opening up onto the 81 mils, and we are going to be seeing a Koenigstiger arrive near the airfield. So this is kind of what we were worried about. The only trouble at this point is it's got to make a lot of ground back. And it's got two Fireflies, two Jumbos, and multiple 17-pounders in its way. So that's going to start taking a lot of morale damage. Koenigstiger does pop one of the Fireflies. And we're going to see it also engage the 17-pounder there. Typhoon AT going to be pinning it down slightly. MG42 going to be dying on the right side as I'm starting to rush up with these half tracks. So earlier on, you saw my half tracks over on the left side mounting up, and that was so that I could push through on this side. But after seeing Whitman on this side alongside the Panther G, I wasn't convinced I'd be able to push forward, so I just moved them over to the right side instead to push forwards with Salt. And what ended up happening was I bumped into the MG squad. I literally just tore them apart with the machine guns. The spear troop going to be opening up with the grenades onto the M3 half track there. But as soon as they do, well, all of my units just tear them apart again. And we're going to just continue to make ground there. And what I can do is even bring up some infantry, which is already on the way, to take advantage of this push. So Jumbo is going to be taking on the Pack 40 there and pinning it down. One of the 17-pounders gets taken out by the Koenigstiger and the Tiger E. My 76mm Sherman comes up and destroys the Stug nicely. But what we're going to see happen is HS-129 is going to be coming in and taking out that M4A3. Also, Betts loses two Spitfires on the right side to this swarm of fighter aircraft. I move across to the left side with this Mustang to take on the HS-129. Tempests are coming in as well. Salt's going to be trying to shoot that down, and he does so. Tempest also following on to the ME-109 and taking that down too. So Salt doing a fantastic job there with his Tempest joining us in the air. Now Salt throughout this game wasn't on comms with us, so he was just working off what he had, like the information he had. But there you have it. After 27 minutes, or 24 minutes and 57 seconds, we win the game by conquest points. So we can reach the 2,500 points mark. The King Tiger couldn't do the job in time, and we win. So there you have it. Kill death wasn't spectacular, honestly. It was a pretty hard time pushing across that airfield, but we made it work. And once we take the ground, well, that's all that matters in the end. At the end of the day, you can roll over those dead bodies as long as you're moving forwards. And although that's not the best way to go about it, it definitely shows in this game with Betts getting a negative KD alongside Salt, even though they both did really well in taking the land. They were starting to get pushed back at the end there as well, and there's quite a lot of planes to consider that were lost throughout that game. I think Betts at the start just losing those Cromwells and the Spitfires at the end there definitely accumulated in his losses, but in general, the majority of the forces were doing a lot of work. In the middle, a lot of my kills, again, planes again, getting shot down. If we actually go to the losses, we can have a look at what I lost. So Tiger E took out a Stuart, an M1 gun. I lose a Mustang and a Lightning there. I also lost the M4A3 to the HS-129, so they're pretty expensive units. And then you've got to account for all of these half-tracks as well that really do add up. In terms of kills, though, the M5A1 got a reasonable amount of kills. The Mustang shot down two airplanes. This P-38 picked off a HS-129, which is definitely worth it. This M5 gun picking off a Panzer IV. This M4A3 did work before it died, taking out a 258, 251-1, and the Stug 3. But in general, there wasn't actually too much going on. Definitely, a lot of the work was down to Val using those Churchill 5s to support our pushes throughout the map. And you can see that is shown through his kills. 2,333, really carrying this game with his Churchill 5s. Pretty good job to Andrea on the right side, make it really hard for us to play in the air with all of his anti-air over there very early on. And he also did a decent job of avoiding a lot of the mosquito bombing, which was quite nice throughout the game. And there you have it. That's pretty much the game. So, quite an interesting one. Definitely nice to see that we can win with allies on an Axis favored map. But there you have it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.